So the world, Satan is trying to make man and woman to be drugged in the world, to be drugged in the power of this flesh, the lust. So when we are drugged in that, we will be just move away from God, and we will be in a different world. So calling to love means what? What Jesus is calling us to love means what? Means number one, knowing the depth of love of Jesus and delighting in that love of Jesus. In Luke chapter 10 verse 41, Jesus tells Martha, 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 you are too busy with many things, but there is only one thing that is needed in life. You are busy with many things. Satan makes you, why can't I do this? Why can't I do that? Why can't I get this one? Why can't I get that? Why can't I ring up to him? Why can't I ring up to her? Why can't I feel like a boring, I will go call this number. I call this number. A kind of making man restless. Whereas God makes us rest. In God we are rested. In God we are delighted. In God we are loved. In the world we have become loveless. The love is not full in the world. So always man is, since I can put this one to fill, I can catch this to fill, I can catch that program to fill, I will do this because through this program I will be full, through that fellow I will be loved, I will be full. So the empty, the world program keeps me empty. So I am restless, I am running around, by what I will be full? Because I am not full. I do this program, still I am not full. I have earned this money, put it in the bank, still I feel, no, I can get one crore. Until I grew, I was talking about lakhs. Until lakhs, I was talking about thousands. Once I get thousands, why can't I get 1 lakh? Why can't I get a few 100 lakhs? Why can't I get a crore? Why can't I get... Because it never gets full. Once I get a friendship with somebody, why can't I do this? Why can't I call the person? Why can't I send a message to the person? Why can't I send some beautiful programs to that person? Why can't I be with that person? Why can't I do something and say lie and go and be with that person? And it never gets full. Because where I am being tied up, until my soul is going to hell, I am empty. So the world program, whereas the moment I recognize Christ, the moment I receive, hey, you know me, Lord, in spite of that, you love me, Lord, I begin to overflow. In love, in Jesus' love, I am not only filled, I am delighted, and I feel that person is suffering. If only that person gets Jesus, he will be blessed. If only this lady gets Jesus, her life will be enriched. So I know he is the way, he is the truth, he is the answer for all the problems. So I am mad. How can I give Jesus to this person? How can I give to Jesus to this situation? So I am busy in giving that Jesus out. So the worldly program and divine programs are different. Calling to love Jesus means to know the depth and delight in the love of Jesus. Second, being loved by Jesus, which is the very, very base. I get time and rejoice. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Lord, for dying for me. Thank you, Lord, for knowing everything of me, that you accept me as I am. Maybe A finds fault at me. Maybe B is not supplying all I need. Maybe I myself is weak. I myself is not able to lift up myself. But you love me, Lord. You accept me as I am, Lord. So being loved is an experience. Only in God we get. Whatever may be, I have completed my MA, I feel like doing MAD. Maybe I feel like doing PhD. Maybe after doing PhD, people may respect me. They may think that I am highly educated. Oh, nothing happened. Why can't I become a reader? Maybe why can't I become a professor? Maybe then they will. So in the world, you never get full. So you are always restless. You are always searching for something. You are always trying to do something. And you are always in tension. Whereas in God, you begin to relax. Be still and know that I am your God. Be still and know whether A loves you or B loves you, I love you. In me you are safe. You are wanted. You are loved. You are cared. So the more I treasure the word, more I spend time with his word, I begin to hear his voice. I begin to hear him. The more time I spend with the word of God, because word of God is the love letter. Word of God is the secret, the language of God. Word of God is the speaking of God to me. So the more I focus on what he speaks, what he tells me, what he wants me to become, the more I become a person on the journey to become full and to make everybody full, which is my call and destiny. So knowing the depth and delight of Jesus, and second, being loved by Jesus, that's what we read in Luke chapter 10 verse 42. Jesus says, Mary had chosen the best one, and it cannot be taken away from her by anybody. Mary had chosen the best one, and it cannot be taken away by anybody or anything. So that is being loved. One is knowing the depth and love of Jesus, spending time with the word of God, trying to know how much he loves me. Another one is delighting myself, being loved, being accepted, thankful to him. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you, Lord. You are with me. So we begin to feel that I have something. So I begin to possess him more and more. So being loved by Jesus, it's an experience in which I lead. So I lead myself. Growing in intimacy with God means I move myself, train myself into knowing the depth of love of Jesus for me by investing my time in reading his word. Second, investing time with myself, that how God loves me. I tell to myself how God loves me. Tell to myself how great you are. Tell to myself how a great treasure you are. And the third thing is, no matter how weak or strong you feel, regardless of your past or your personality, you can be ablaze with a passion for Jesus. You can be used by Jesus. You can be a treasure for Jesus. You can carry Jesus to this broken world. You begin to see, not only as person being loved by Jesus, how treasure you are and how this treasure is needed for this world. And because of that, he has given the treasure to you. So you are ablaze with the love. So when you are burning with the fire, whomever comes near the fire, they all share the warmth of the fire. They all share that fire to cook their food, to make it tasty, to make it digestive. Yes. So you become ablaze with passion for Jesus. So God pours his spirit that we ablaze with love. That's what we read in Romans 5:5. God's love is poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit.